It is elimination Sunday for the Winston Cup Series playoff drivers as they head into America's heartland today at the Kansas Speedway, the currently recent track on the NASCAR Winston Cup circuit that opened up in January of 2001. Last time out at Charlotte was a bit of a crash fest that saw multiple playoff drivers have problems, and ultimately led to Dale Jarrett getting his second win of the year, dating back to his last win at Dover in June. Kansas Speedway is one of the more similar cookie-cutter type tracks compared to the other recent Winston Cup track, Chicagoland and Las Vegas. Intermediate in length, 1.5 miles long. End of today, 12 drivers will be whittled down to 8 in their fight for a spot in the championship 4 at Phoenix.
Hello and welcome to the Kansas Speedway for the running of the Protection 1 400. Tell us a little bit about this track, Barney.
This track is a 1.5 mile trioval like Chicagoland and Las Vegas. Most of these drivers are still learning things about this track. We should see quite a show.
The Monte Carlo car will try for another top five finish in this one.
Well, his team is real excited about their success so far. In fact, I believe they'll have another top five race as long as he keeps his car out of trouble.
Matt Kenseth, who's currently in the top 10 in points, will try to reach that next step, the top five.
He's been working hard this season, and it is paying off so far. He'll need a good finish in this one to gain some spots.
Robbie Gordon hasn't run well in his qualifying attempts at the speedways this year.
Man, that's true. Maybe he likes having to pass all those cars on race day. I know I would prefer to start towards the front, and I'm sure he would too. But hey, he'll get there with some patience.
See how they'll line up for the start. In the front row are the Ganassi Racing Dodge and the 41 car. In the second row are the Valvoline Pontiac and the 43 car. Starting the race from row 3 are the Sprint Dodge and the Sirius Satellite Radio Dodge. The fourth row has the 16 car and the Tide Ford. The 83 car, the NASCAR Winston Cup points leader, will start in the ninth spot. The sixth row has the Citgo Ford and the 23 car. In row 7 are the Dale Jr. Chevrolet and the 24 car. Starting the race from row 8 are the GM Goodrich Service Plus Chevrolet and the 26 car. And in row 9 are the UPS Ford and the Lowe Chevrolet. Starting in row 10 will be the Napa Auto Parts Chevrolet and the Home Depot Pontiac. In row 11 are the 27 car and the Altel Ford. In row 12 are the M&M's Pontiac and the 46 car. Row 13 finds the Dodge Dealer's UAW Dodge and the DeWalt Power Tools Ford. The 14th row has the Kodak Chevrolet and the BAM Racing Dodge. In row 15 are the Dodge Dealer's UAW Dodge and the Interstate Batteries Pontiac. Starting the race from row 16 are the Pennzoil Chevrolet and the Caterpillar Dodge. Row 17 has the 5 car and the Rubbermaid Ford. Starting in row 18 will be the Avalon Ford. row 19 are the Motorcraft Ford and the 98 car. In row 20 are the Square D Chevrolet and the Singular Wireless Chevrolet. Back in row 21, we have the America Online Chevrolet and the UAW Delphi Chevrolet. And rounding out the field is the 63 car.
And that's your starting lineup for today's race here at Kansas. Last year was the first time the Winston Cup Series ever raced in America's heartland. That race was won by Jeff Gordon. Jeff Gordon is currently one of the only two drivers that have punched their ticket into the round of eight, along with Dale Jarrett, who won the last intermediate track on Sunday at Lowe's. Sterling Marlin won the pole on Friday evening. I want to give a shout out to John Andretti qualifying fourth, Greg Biffle qualifying in ninth. Drivers we're obviously going to be watching today: Kevin Harvick, Tony Stewart, Bobby Labonte, Rusty Wallace is another one that we're watching, Jimmy Johnson, and we're also watching Ricky Rudd. Pace car is off, and we're green at Kansas. For one lap complete, Sterling Marlin is your race leader as they head off into turn one. Got Kyle Petty up there in fifth, and they're definitely a fast weekend in qualifying for the Dodges as they've taken up the first three rows. You got the 41 of Jimmy Spencer and the 10 of Johnny Benson up there in third and second, non-playoff drivers. Guys like Dylan Merway and Mark Martin are currently the highest two in points. Their goal today is to just finish. I'd argue you could probably throw guys like Matt Kenseth and Kevin Harvick into that mix as well. Dylan Merway getting set to close in on the 40 is Sterling Marlin. He's going to have the lead here using the apron and barely take the lead here at the start finish. Marlin still holding a tough here on the outside lane. Very rare to see with a track that's got fresh pavement like Kansas that's only a year old. Seeing him trying to make the outside work, Marlin eventually dropped down, heading down the backstretch. Coming through turn four. And then back down towards turn one again, you got Johnny Benson up there as well. Sterling Marlin is another playoff driver. We're going to have to be watching him throughout the afternoon today. He is looking to try to keep his playoff dreams alive. Heading down towards turn one again. Marlin on the outside, he's probably one of the only cars that can really make that outside lane work as they dive back off towards turn three again. Marlin still holding strong on the outside. That's brought Dale Earnhardt Jr. up there to try to battle. Now Dylan ends up overshooting. He goes way wide in turn one, got out towards the gravel up there in turn four. Now he falls all the way to fourth, trying to take the spot and side draft Jimmy Spencer heading into turn three. Dylan Murray getting the momentum back. He's going to try to take Junior and Marlin three wide, going all the way downstairs. Maybe barely has the spot over Marlin, who's side by side for fourth going into turn one. Washes up into the eight of Earnhardt Jr. Dylan is still up into the kitty litter. Here comes the 41 and the 88 of Jimmy Spencer. Big contact coming off of turn two. Battle for third. Nine laps complete here in the Protection 1 400. Dylan Murway is trying to run down Johnny Benson, who has a second gap heading into turn one. Now it's 6 tenths of a second heading into turn three. Dylan's starting to run down the lead with Sterling Marlin, as we're going to give you your update of the four playoff drivers to watch. Jimmy Johnson, 13th. Matt Kenseth running 19th. Hit Kenseth's goal. He could finish and theoretically be good enough to advance into the round of eight. Then you got Tony Stewart to watch as well. Kevin Harvick's also up there in the top 10. Kenseth, Harvick, I'd argue Tony Stewart. Stewart doesn't really have to worry a whole lot about having to worry about falling out of the top eight to advance next week. But he also can't rely on points. That's his issue. That's kind of that big hornet's nest I mentioned earlier in pre-race this morning. It's basically a hornet's nest with Ricky Rudd, Kevin Harvick. I'd probably argue Jimmy Johnson, Rusty Wallace, and both the Joe Gibbs Pontiacs. It was also announced earlier yesterday that Joe Gibbs will be switching to Chevrolet for the 2003 campaign, leaving Pontiac's involvement to just the MB2 Motorsports cars of Johnny Benson. And next season, it is also being reported that Ricky Craven's team over at Cal Wells will be switching to Pontiac for 1 year before eventually switching to Chevrolet development in 2004. Got Kevin Harvick up there in the top five. He's okay on points if need be. Jimmy Johnson, without a doubt, has to win. He's crashed twice in this round. Bobby Labonte, I'd argue, is in the same boat. That's your playoff update so far up to this point. Johnson and Labonte have to win. Rusty Wallace and Matt Kenseth are also in that conversation as well. You probably throw Ricky Rudd into that mix as well. Johnny Benson takes the lead back from Dylan Murway heading into turn two. Heading down the backstretch. Some pretty great racing early on. Didn't really expect this compared to yesterday's Busch race here at Kansas. Everybody was kind of... around the bottom most of the day. Kind of saw maybe a handful of cars playing with... running a middle groove. So far, you can actually make some speed. Over in the top and middle lanes, believe it or not. Especially the middle. Weirdly enough. Kind of unusual to see there. Sixteen laps complete here in the Protection 1-400. Jeff Burton up there in third. Eliminated in the last round at Bristol. Darlington winner. At this point, he's just looking to get some momentum heading into the 2003 campaign. Complete. Oh, big contact and a big moment for the 83 of Dylan Murway getting tipped off the bumper of Jeff Burton, mounting into the 8 of Earnhardt Jr. You got to wonder if either of those cars have a tire rub. This brings Mark Martin into the Hornet's nest, and Jeff Burton gets turned around and up into traffic. I think that got... can't tell. There are a couple cars on pit road. That might have collected Johnny Benson. The caution has come out. First time today. Oh! Yeah, he just clipped the 10 of Johnny Benson as he came across the track. Pace car is off for the restart. Green flag back into the air as we race back towards turn number one. It is Mark Martin, the race leader. Looks like Kevin Harvick up there in fourth. Jimmy Johnson, he's up there in eighth, but his goal and his mission today, win. He's got Dale Jarrett up there. Last week's winner at Charlotte, sitting there in second, looking to go two in a row, add some extra momentum heading into the round of eight next week. Some great tracks coming up for him. Ran strong at the Rock in February. Ran strong at Martinsville earlier this year. And I'd argue definitely knows his way around a road course. Road course oval hybrid. He ran pretty well at the second Daytona race in August, or a couple months ago. No, the road course race, I should say. Second leg of that Florida tour. Dylan Murway gets past Kevin Harvick for the fourth position. He's gonna nudge Junior up the track, get him into that high stuff, and Junior is gonna lose about three spots out of this. Dylan's closing in. He's got about 7/10 of a second on Mark Martin. Heading into turn one. Dylan trying to make that second lane work off of two. He's starting to lose a little bit of momentum. That's kind of the time of the run. You're going to start seeing a lot of guys start to search a little bit heading into the corners. Dylan Murray is racing Kevin Harvick pretty hard. And that's helped him break away from Harvick for a third. He's got 0.2 seconds. Dillon closed in. He's trying to change his groove heading into the corner. He moves up. And that actually helped him catch Dale Jarrett off of turn two that time. And Mark Martin. So he got a three-horse race battling for the lead here in Kansas. Dillon drops low. Remember, just a reminder, the apron and that white line is legal to use. You can go down there to make a pass compared to Talladega a couple weeks ago. Typically, not a lot of guys like to do that because there's a lot of dirt down there sometimes if you run down there for a little too long. Dillon closing in on the six of Mark Martin. He's going to get a huge head of momentum off at turn four. Move Dillon Merway to the point. Here at Kansas. Martin crosses low. Off of turn four. Side by side for the lead here at Kansas. This is what they promised when they built this track. A lot of side by side racing. You're definitely seeing your money's worth today. Two chasers get together in turn one. See if there's any damage on either of them. Looks like everybody keeps it clean and green. No smoke yet. Looks like they're already starting to get green flag pit stops down there on pit road. Got a small batch of cars. Oh, Dillon into the wall. Contact with Mark Martin. Dillon slides through the grass. Somehow they still stay green, but that's a lot of time that he just lost. Look at that. That's all the way to eighth right now. Got Michael Waltrip hanging on in the top 10. Dillon charges the corner. Got a lot of speed. He's going to try to take it three wide, which is not really what people expect to do here at Kansas. That did not work out for either of them. As Jimmy Johnson is going to be the big beneficiary of this. He's going to get a couple spots out of all that shuffling in turn one. Lap before halfway here at Kansas. So far it looks to me, I can't really see as a leader there off in the distance. Dillon Merway washes up into Jimmy Johnson to take fourth. Looks like we're getting ready for green flag pit stops here in a few moments. I think I saw Tony Stewart and Kevin Harvick mixing it up there for position. Kevin Harvick was robbed of a victory a few weeks ago at Bristol as the caution has come out. They're saying, race control is saying debris over in turn four, it looks like. They make their way through turn four and to the caution flag.
Just 2 seconds back now, 2 seconds.
And that debris was from the 99 of Jeff Burton, and I think someone ran over it. So there was a huge checkup just past start finish. As we head back to the caution flag. It looks like we're going to be beginning green flag stops here. Everybody comes down.
except for probably the handful of lap cars that pitted before. So this caution kind of flips this race on its head, if you could say. And quite a bit of beating and banging just to get in your pit stall. Wow. 43 of your best drivers in the world, everyone. Dylan Murway came out 8th or 5th after that pit stop. Dylan Murray takes the green. Definitely a quick start for them. Slow start for everybody else. As they head back towards turn number 1, there's 5 cars that are currently a lap down. I think I saw Sadler's up there. The 46 of Frank Kimmel did not get going. Dylan's going to get some speed back in his car, battling the 8 of Dale Earnhardt Jr. As they come off of turn 4. Mark Martin, Kevin Harvick mixing it up for 3rd. Now Dylan's going to try to switch to the top side, maybe get some momentum. Ricky Craven is for position. He was one of those drivers that pitted during that caution. There's Earnhardt Jr. down there in 7th, trying to side draft. Oh, Dylan up the hill. Dylan into the wall. Definitely lost a few spots there. Now Dylan's falling back to 8th. Battling with the 20 of Tony Stewart. Coming out of turn 2 down the back stretch. Hopefully we can get some speed back into his car. Coming through turn 4 again.
You got some passes left in there somewhere.
40 laps complete.
There's going to be an announcement for the re-revised 2003 Winston Cup schedule coming out this week with start times. I know there was initial plans back in June, but a couple more night races were added. Supposedly Kansas's date in April, this brief date in April, will be a night race, along with the first Darlington race. That will switch to an afternoon race as well. Next year will be the final time the Winston Cup drivers will race on the Homestead Roval configuration in the round of 8. Las Vegas will also get a second race as well, in wake of Rockingham moving into the round of 12. In the playoffs, Rockingham will be a night race, obviously as a placeholder for more future expansion out west for the NASCAR series. With California currently lobbying for a second race during or at night, possibly on Saturday night, possibly on Sunday night in the near future. A little bit of schedule drama to look forward to in the future as well. Dylan Murray closing up on the 29 of Kevin Harvick. 3 wide for position. That's the only time you can get 3 wide, is you here at a track like Kansas. Get him on the straightaway if you have a lot of speed. Dylan was able to do just that and pass 4 cars. Bill Elliott is not for position. He was one of the drivers that first made a pit stop before that second caution. Now Dale Jarrett and Jimmy Johnson going toe-to-toe here for the win. They got the 12-car Ryan Newman to deal with. Newman currently holding up the and Terry Labonte as well. I've just got to wonder, maybe some people are laying picks
That obviously didn't matter because Dylan did a great roll through the corner. He's going to go side by side with Jimmy Johnson heading out of turn four. Arc it deep this time. And he's going to take second away from Jimmy Johnson. Brian Newman and Terry Labonte are currently acting as a pick to slow up the 88 of Dale Jarrett. Jimmy Johnson took a couple shots in 3 and 4 at the 83. Dylan's going to arc it to the inside, trap Terry in the middle, move him up the track, get Jarrett up into the loose stuff. Jarrett is able to power through off of turn 2 this time. Side by side for the lead, Jarrett takes the spot. Not a lot of cars. You didn't really expect a lot of cars in practice Saturday to try that second and go up towards that top groove. Everybody expected Kansas over the years to change its groove and evolve. And as the track ages, you're going to start seeing more and more lanes open up. Dale Jarrett's making it work. Sterling Marlin's making it work. In fact, that's how the Dodge guys got so fast, is they were able to use that second groove as well. Dylan's going to take the lead from Dale Jarrett, allows Terry Labonte to kind of play prevent defense, messing with Ryan Newman. Obviously wonder if manufacturer orders might come into play here late in this race. You got Ryan Newman as a Ford. He could possibly play spoiler with Dylan Merway, such as allowing Dale Jarrett to go by, as they're both Fords. And you just got to wonder if you're the crew chief, you're going to start hearing, these guys are going to start playing team orders. Get by him. Don't let him mess with you. And just like that, Terry Labonte is continuing to hold up the 88 of Dale Jarrett. Dale Jarrett is not liking this as Dylan forces his way past the 88 to move Dylan Merway to the point. 19 to go. Jimmy Johnson moves to the second to third spot. Jarrett trying to make that outside work. Definitely making it work there. Coming off of turn four. 50 laps complete. Caution comes out again. Earnhardt Jr. trying to play spoiler heading down the back. Jarrett takes the high side. Dylan charges it in deep. Earnhardt Jr. up the hill. Off of turn four. And to the caution flag they go. Looks like debris on the front stretch. Dylan just ran over it. I don't think it's going to cut a tire. And it was off of Dale Jarrett again, or Jeff Burton again. Quick, had the debris off of his machine. This could get fun. Green flag back into the air. Dylan with a good start. He kind of jumped that one. And Johnson with a nice runoff too. Dylan drives up to try to crowd him. They're playing defense right now, heading down the backstretch into turn three. Dylan gonna try to dime in the corner again. Oh, into the wall, off the corner. Dylan keeps the lead. Bill Elliott gets into the 83. Johnson to the point. This is what Jimmy Johnson needs to have happen. He needs to win this race if he wants to advance into the round of eight. I talked with crew chief Chad Knaus earlier this week. He said they put Jeff Gordon's 2001 winning setup in that car when Gordon won that race. In the first race here, he had a fast car afternoon. Very similar scenario here for the 48. 11 to go.
Ricky Craven is for position. Elliott Sadler in the 21 is not. Sadler trying to... This is not what Dylan needed to see. He's got no Chevy help to try to play defense for the other Fords because he's got a whole gaggle of them around him. He's got Sadler, not for position. He could slow up the 83. He's got Ricky Craven, who's just looking to win at this point. He's got the 88 of Dale Jarrett, who is slated to be a possible championship favorite heading into Phoenix, and especially heading into the round of eight. Down towards turn three. Three wide, coming off of turn four. Jarrett making the pass. Now arcing it back towards turn one again. Eight to go. Sorry, nine to go. Here at Kansas, in the Protection 1400. It's been a great day for racing. Seen a lot of hard battles for the lead, hard battles throughout the pack. Getting reports that Jeff Gordon might be down a cylinder. The Talladega winner, he's definitely looking to obviously just finish. That's his goal. So we'll see how that plays out for him. You see Gordon just trying to get out of the way with the problems he's having. Dylan closing in, closing up on Dale Jarrett. Dylan closing in on the 88. Ryan Newman, he could play defense for Dylan, but Dylan's just got a faster car. That just made this Hornet's Nest a lot more interesting. Five to go. Dylan trying to charge in side by side. Dylan and Jarrett up the hill. Both of them are racing hard. They're racing clean. Contact again. They're trying to make it happen. Trying to keep that car going. Out towards turn four. Jarrett takes the spot back. Four laps of racing to go. Let's watch the final four playoff drivers that we're looking at. Ricky Rudd, 11th. Kevin Harvick, 7th. He's in at this point. Matt Kenseth is an 8th. He's also pretty much in at this point. So all we're watching, Jimmy Johnson, Tony Stewart, Ricky Rudd, and Rudd could just finish. If we're looking at this correctly, Rusty Wallace and Bobby Labonte are nowhere to be seen in that. We'll break it down post-race. Dylan's watching up the track. He's out of it. Possibly. Five to go here at Kansas. Racing through turns three and four again. Three cars battling for the win. Here at the Protection 1400 at Kansas. Four laps of racing to go. Jimmy Johnson is pretty much out of it at this point because we are past the red flag lap. If a caution were to come out right now, this race would be over. As of right now, Kevin Harvick has locked a spot in the round of eight. So we're leaving this battle between Ricky Rudd, Rusty Wallace, Tony Stewart, Bobby Labonte, and Jimmy Johnson. Of those five, one of them will keep their hopes alive. Matt Kenseth also got plenty of points as well. Dylan Murway up to second. He's got three laps to run down the 88 of Dale Jarrett. Two to go at Kansas. This is exciting. Racing. Half a second separates both Dale Jarrett and Dylan Murway. Possible championship four appearance for those two. Half a second will separate those two drivers. Ryan Newman is the lapped car. He's currently laying a pick. Very odd to see this between two Fords. That's allowing Dylan to close up. Off of turn four, the crowd on their feet. White flag here at Kansas. Dylan Murway closes in big, heading into turn three. Newman up the hill. Could this be it? Two horse race down the back. Jarrett got a run. Contact is made. Dylan trying to crowd the 88. Don't give him the track. Contact. They're both loose. Out of turn four. It is not enough. Dylan Murway is your winner here at Kansas, punching his ticket to the round of eight.
What an exciting finish. Yeah, these NASCAR Winston Cup races can be hundreds of laps, yet when all is said and done, sometimes there are just a few tenths or even less separating the leaders. That was incredible. The Monte Carlo car is the big winner in this one. And rightfully so. He was fast all race long. That whole team deserves a lot of credit for a great win. From all of us here at EA Sports at MRN, thanks for joining us today, and we'll see you next time.
Whew. That was arguably the best race of the chase up to this point. Dylan Murway pulls his Chevrolet into victory lane, returning back to the back and black design, heading into the round of eight. Look at all that extra momentum he's got that he's carrying to the next race. And he's got some good tracks. He's a pretty good road ringer. He won the race at the Daytona Road Course back in August during the Florida Tour. He won at Martinsville earlier this year. Could he go for the Martinsville sweep? Maybe punch his ticket into the championship four? A lot of momentum on Dylan Murway's side. A lot of momentum on Dale Jarrett's side as well. Both of them finishing 1-2. Today, Ricky Craven ends up third. Tony Stewart fourth. Earnhardt Jr. fifth. Jimmy Johnson. Heartbreak for him into the round of eight, as he will not make it. Kevin Harvick, Matt Kenseth, Mark Martin, and Ricky Rudd will. Jeff Gordon also with his win at Talladega. He was able to finish this race down a cylinder, but Bobby Labonte will not make it into the round of eight, finishing 14th. Tony Stewart will not make it into the round of eight. Tony Stewart will make it into the round of eight. So Joe Gibbs' efforts continue to live on as we're looking through the rest of the unofficial results. Tough break for pretty much the entire Hendrick camp that's not Jimmy Johnson. Bill Elliott. Wow. Jeff Gordon. He was down a cylinder late, had to pull down to pit road. Obviously not what he expected to go in his first visit out to Kansas. As Sterling Marlin was eliminated, obviously with his engine problems. We take a look at the official round of eight drivers. Jeff Gordon, Dale Jarrett, Dylan Murway, Kevin Harvick, Tony Stewart, Matt Kenseth, Mark Martin, and Ricky Rudd all advance into the round of eight as they have one last hurdle before they get to the championship four.
as we break down the rest of this race. So, your awards for the week: Sterling Marlin won the pole, Blue and Motor. Dale Jarrett led the most laps. Ricky Rudd passed the most cars. Jeff Burton had the fastest lap. Dylan Murway was the best rookie of the race. And Michael Waltrip made the most exciting pass of the afternoon. Probably to avoid when Jeff Gordon lost a... was down a cylinder. 14 drivers are on the pole. The Jackpot 5, it was announced, will not return for 2003. Or the Winston No Bowl, I should say. Chevrolet is a 22-point lead over Ford, heading into the round of 8. In terms of the Manufacturer Championship. And the EA Sports Lap Champion Award, Dylan Murway has a 420 lap difference over Mark Martin. Heading into the round of 8. The review of the round of 8 tracks. 3 different tracks. 3 challenging tracks. You got the short track confines of Martinsville. You got the Homestead Road Course. And you got The Rock in prime time for the first time ever to set the championship for. How about that? That's 3 very diverse racetracks heading into this next round of 8. We'll see you next Sunday at Martinsville.